Hi, YouTube. Just took me four times pushing my button to get it to go on record. Yeah, anyway, I was going to talk about how to guard your heart from the triangulation that narcissists will cause. I have a lot of practice in that area. Just a moment. With parents and a sibling, and pitting siblings against each other. And I've seen it all. I've seen people do it, and I've had it happen to me. I've had it happen in marriages. It's here, the biggest tip I can give you. First, they're always going to do that. That's what they do to people. It's a real common game. It's a game to them. They don't care. And it's not only pitting people against each other, it's to see kind of who the winner is that they can take advantage of by manipulating the whole situation. And but when it's in a relationship, there's times that the innocent party will end up looking like the guilty party. Because not only has the person that you're close to betrayed you, but a lot of times it will involve friends and the whole situation. I've got friends around here that have seen me live through things and live through them with me. So they're really aware of it too. Or some of them had it happen to them. But my point is to not, don't take that jealousy you feel. That's a natural reaction. Don't take it to heart. You have every right to act upon your feelings or say how you feel. You may not be validated. If you go into the thing, if you're going somewhere with somebody that you care about that doesn't care about you in the same way, rest assured, your heart's going to be hurt over and over and over again, whether it's parents or a loved one or whoever these people are that act like that. That's their personality. And if you guard your heart in that sense, like, I just know, I mean, you can hope. This is part of where in the scriptures, their discernment or deciphering a person's nature and to have righteous judgment on your own behalf. There's different scriptures to guard you against these people. There's certain scriptures that they will use against you, like love your neighbor. Yes, my neighbor indicates that they live in my same vicinity. If they're living in my same vicinity, we are like-minded. And that's exactly how neighbor is described. It's not how they're using it, not at all. So just guard your hearts like that. You go somewhere, it is a little easier. I mean, it doesn't take away from the pain of the whole situation that, you know, when you find out that you love somebody that, well, your love may not have been as strong and theirs may not have been as strong because they weren't who you thought they were, or vice versa, whatever. Whatever excuse they're gonna make is more like it if you're dealing with the narcissist. So in that respect, you were probably steadfast, honest, and monogamous in that. So to have these feelings, even if you're separated and distant or more companions like Doug or I or whatever, that's not my thing. He put me in that position and I took it on and said, okay, then this is what it is and I'm not playing your game. But if you want to go out and do something on me, just be human enough to write me these papers so I can get away from your nasty germs. You know? So, I mean, that's not a lot to ask. But if there's any doubt in your mind about anybody, and in fact, if you're not close to them in spirit, I don't know why some people will still be hugging and snugging on things that are just entirely disgusting. I don't know if that's your position either. Hopefully not for you, you know. But, or maybe your mission is to whatever it takes, maybe to soften a monster's heart. I have no clue, no clue what people are thinking. I just know that I try with all my heart, and the any indication I get that they're cold, just as a renewal on a daily basis, that they're just really not all there, you know. So that's dealing with the, it's not even our jealousy, it's somebody else's. It's something that they put on somebody else to participate on putting on you. And sometimes the other people are unaware of it. And sometimes they're aware of it and they actually help. You know, there's different scenarios, different ways that can go. And even in families, you know, sometimes it's not going to happen, but you don't know when it will. And it, you might end up being like the laughing stock or the black sheep or the one that people think to slight because they don't feel good about themselves, you know. So there's lots of things that people have to go through with these type of people, you know, that is ungodly. It's horrible. It's wicked. You're living in some wicked times. So don't feel bad about self-righteous judgment when you're looking at somebody else. Rest assured that there's other people with minds and hearts that are sane. And we see these people. We see them move and we see how they roll. You know, I can spot these things from, like I say, around the world. I see you, I feel you, I can't get the feeling off me, you know. So, all right, everybody, I just wanted to talk about that. Don't feel bad, it's not jealousy. If you think about it, it's a manipulated situation to play with emotions that aren't even yours. It's all satanic. Don't claim it. I mean, it hurts your heart. That's not jealousy. That's what I'm trying to say. All right, everybody. I love you so much. Peace and love from Pine City, Minnesota, USA. Have a good night or day, wherever you're at.